What is going on, ladies and gentlemen of the internet and YouTube? I'm Freddy Fuego, Flaming Hot Entertainment, MultiPlatGameTrap.com, the people's voice and your favorite average gamer. Going to be bringing you a quick overview of the multiplayer component of Medal of Honor Warfighter, its options, and what you can expect when you log in and get into the multiplayer part. All right, you're going to see four tiles in the beginning. These four tiles is for ones for quick match, recent servers that you've been on, your fire team buddies, and then your party. Your party can be accessed through this tile or just hitting the select button. I'm just going to hit the select button. And you see right here, you know, game activity. You hit R1. It goes to your friends playing online, various other games, and, you know, on this game, then you hit the right analog stick up and down, and it just scroll you. You only could do when you're going on here is the ones that you're actually scrolled through. R1 again, you see your invites. Your party system is open, and you can change that. Here's your party, and it could be up to you and 9 other friends, a total of 10 people. So it's 10v10. The game online is 10v10, a total of 20 people. And you need 6 members from the same platoon to play other platoon ranked. So as you see there, I haven't gotten into that. You can lock your slot in there, or you can change slots by clicking on this and see, unlock it. Then I can actually change slots, switch slots. So go to whatever fire team I want. You can invite people from specific and designate them to where they want to, where which slot they're gonna be in. Then right here, the VOIP, which doesn't work right now because you could only when the whole game's out of the, like, the game's finished or beforehand, everybody can talk in the lobby, but in the game there's no sort of chat whatsoever. You could hear people, but you can't talk, and it's just, they need to patch that like ASAP. That's why you need to do betas for all platforms, so you find out what works and what doesn't. The party system, VOIP party, auto party, fire team, and those are disabled right now because I'm just in the fire team, the party function. But when you're in the game, you can actually go back, press start, then hit select, and come back to the same screen and change it. Now, it does have a server browser, which is right here, and you're gonna see different game types, and again you have to scroll through it and then pick the ones that are actually on the part that scroll through. So it's kinda weird, it doesn't just, like, you keep pressing down and it just keeps on going, it'll just actually come all the way down. Hit refresh. You can edit the filter. Say you just want team deathmatch, you know, hotspot, sector control, combat mission. Those are the 5 game types. And then these are the maps right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 maps. And they have another map coming, I believe. Let me look at the box. Yeah, Zero Dark 30 map. So that's gonna be coming up soon as a free DLC if you got the limited edition. So it's Novi Grand, Warzone, Basilan Aftermath, Sarajevo Stadium, Alfara, Cliffside, Shilgor Valley, Tanguan Jungle, Somalia Stronghold, and Hira Dunes. And then free slots, party fits, you can play hardcore, which is awesome. Then, you know, refresh and save. Then it actually has recent servers that I've been on. These are all the recent servers I've been on. game types I've been on. Matchmaking is basically quick match, but you get to select what game type that you want to play, and it tells you right there on the left hand side the game type, the rules, the game modes. And there's, like I said, there's five. This one is not one of them. It's actually these two right here are not game types. These are just a mix between the two. So then here you got the guns, and I'm using right now the G3, the HK G3 Spetsnaz. All right, the optic eye right now, you see Spectre DR, low power dual sight. It actually zooms in when you hit the R3. Gets a little zoom, closer zoom. So you could hit triangle to go to the next part of the weapon. And you see there's various things on each weapon. All right, the muzzle. There's three different types of muzzles, and you can actually view them before you even unlock them. Just go to it, and you'll see. So, and it shows the different weapon stats on the top right-hand corner, how they change for every piece of hardware you move. And every time you die, you can actually change this. So you can change your gun 50 times if you die 50 times. Or you can just change it by pressing start, go to a corner, switch it out, and then when you spawn up the next time, it'll be changed. So now let's just go to this. And I got this. This is the newest clip that I got. So I got that. Then there's tons of paint jobs. Look at this fucking all purple joint. Right now I'm just picking that. There's so many of them. I mean, it's just real nice to have all those type of stuff on the gun, and being able to do that while you're playing a game. There is, let me count them. One, it's U.S. OG, United States OGA, Canadian JOT. Well, I'll just say Canada, U.S. There's three U.S., one Canada, one Korea, one Norway. That's another U.S. Russian Federation, Poland, another U.S., Germany, United Kingdom, Australia, and Sweden. And each character has their different name on it. So you have six classes. You got the sniper, the assaulter, demolitions, heavy gunner, point man, and spec ops. And I just unlocked the demolition guy just on the last game I played. And you could actually, hold on. Say I want to change. Each character can be changed throughout different countries. And they all got different guns. So. Fight for honor. Then on the top right hand corner, you'll see the different support actions they have. Then this is your platoon, basically your clan. Platoon card. Bam. Top 70. Stats, service record. I did 161 things. So. These are all my accomplishments. Oh no, there's 161 accomplishments. And it just all loads. So, you know, 161 things is you got of accomplishments. There goes all of them. I'm just running through them real quick. I'm not trying to be on this all day. I actually want to play the game. The game is a lot better than what I expected it to be. I guess maybe it's because I had very low expectations for the game, and they just seem to, the game overshadowed it. Like I said, the only problem I've found with the game is the VOIP and top players. And here's the top players scores per minutes. And you got, let's see what the filter is. Okay, let's see what the KD is. All right, you do that. You can actually do by the KD, and you see right here, I'm 5,000. Yeah, I suck. Top platoons. Let's see. I'm 770, and I'm only one person in it. All right, and then the options. The options right here is, you know, the game options, subtitles, which I don't need. Weapon zoom, hold, peek, lean, yep. Let's do a toggle. Aim assist. It's got different things. I keep it on default. Sensitivity a little bit in the middle. Yeah, vertical look normal. And this is basically just to switch the lean and the class ability between the up on the D-pad and L2. As you can see, it'll just switch it. And that's pretty much it. Audio. Audio. I turned down the music because all the music on this game is copywritten through EA, so they'll give you copyright strikes for it. I tried to upload my video yesterday, and just because I had music, I had to chop off part of the music, the gameplay, you know what I'm saying, part of the end and the beginning of the videos to get the music out of it. Sound effects, it lets you select between desktop, home theater, and TV. Video, adjust the brightness, you know, colorblind thing, that's actually good. This is to adjust your screen. So, and then, you know, redeem codes for the PlayStation Store. Might be for different things, I don't know. I really don't know. If anybody knows what that's for, please let me know. Excuse my squeaky wooden chair from the 1950s. Anyways, man, I hope y'all enjoy this video. It's just, I wanted to show you the overview. This is the things that I actually enjoy doing, finding out about the game, so I don't feel as confused when I'm playing it and trying to navigate throughout the options, all the options menu. And like I said, when you're in the game, you could always press start and then hit select, and it'll bring you to this part, you know, your invites and all that good stuff. I'll actually record some more part and show you how to back out of a game. And you could always switch your characters, switch your gun styles, all that good stuff while you're playing the game, is when you die or just by going into the start menu and doing it, and then when you load up the next time, it'll have been changed to whatever you changed it to. I've been your host, your commentator, Freddy Fuego, Flamin' Hot Entertainment, MultiplatGameTrap.com. And remember to check out all my content partners, subscribe to their channels if you like their channel, and go to the website if you haven't already. It's free to become a member. There's a lot of great content put up on there, from modding your controllers to different games, from PC gaming to Xbox 360 to Wii, everything, basically all type of gaming stuff going on there. I appreciate you watching the video. Let me know if this was helpful. This is what I like doing, finding out the ins and outs of games. So I enjoy the game. You could always shoot me a message on my PSN. You probably seen some gameplay of it. It's FRED-E-FUEGO is my PSN ID. I only accept messages, don't accept friend invites. Peace, love, and hair grease. Haters, keep on hating. If you haven't been doing it, you need to get gaming.